Good morning, dear students. Welcome to the class. Welcome to your new class. And I'm your GK teacher. And I'm going to teach you GK. So all of you open unit first. First unit is the world of animals. So today I'm going to teach you the first chapter, that is amphibian. All of you open page number 4, chapter number 1. That is amphibian. What are amphibians? Amphibians are the animals which live in water as well as on land. The word amphibian comes from a Greek word amphibious, which means double life. Animals live a double life or both kind of life. Means they will live in water as well as in on land. So they play or live both the life of water and on land. Amphibians are animals that spend one part of their life in water and other part on land. For example, frog, toad, salamander, newts, cassiterns, or lions. These all are the amphibians. Now we will do the exercise. Take the correct statement and cross the wrong ones to getting more about, to knowing more about these animals who live in water or on land. So we will do the exercise to know more about the amphibians. The first point is amphibians are invertebrate. Amphibians are invertebrates. So dear children, do you know that amphibians are invertebrate? No. What are invertebrate means? Invertebrate means the animals whose don't have a backbone. They lack of backbone. So amphibians are having backbones. They are vertebrate. This statement is wrong. Okay? Now, the second point. Second point is amphibians are cold-blooded animals. Amphibians are
amphibians,
most of the amphibians, or maybe all the amphibians live in in the moist place. Especially frog and toad, they lay egg in the jelly-like mucus. So they will not lay egg on the land. This is wrong. Number fourth point is, most amphibians have moist skin that also help breathe. Yes? So, what about you? It is correct or wrong? It is correct. Amphibians have moist skin that helps them to breathe because they have to live in water also and on land also. So, they are having their skins are moist that they easily live in water as well as on land. Next, fifth point, amphibians have hair and fur on their body. Amphibians have hair and fur. Their children, as they have lived double life, as you all know, they have to live in land and as well as in water. That's why they do not have hair or fur. If they live in water, so what is the use of the hair or fur? So that is why this statement is okay. Now, then sixth point is, adult amphibians eat spiders, beetles and worms. Yes, it is correct. Because adult amphibians eat small animals. Mostly frogs, toads and salamanders eat insects. So that is why adult amphibians eat smaller animals or smaller insects. Or you can write spider, worms. These all are insects and worms. Seventh point, amphibians are found on every continent except Antarctica. Yes, dear children, amphibians are found on each and every continent. Means they live in habitats that range from forest to desert. So, except Antarctica, they live on every continent. It is also correct. Now, the eighth point. The scientific study of amphibians and reptiles is called herpetology. Yes, scientific study of amphibians are herpetology. It is also correct. Now, the ninth point. They are the world environmental indicators. They are the world's environmental indicator. Also is correct because according to ecological perspectives, they are regarded as good ecological environmental indicators. So this is also correct. Now the last but not the least point is, that is the 10th point. Some amphibians have teeth and do and some do not. Some amphibians
This is also correct statement. This is the correct statement.
Some amphibians have teeth and some do not. Frogs are also having teeth. They are called as vominine teeth. Means they are located on the upper jaws. Small teeth are located on the upper jaws. They are known as vominine teeth. So that is why amphibians have teeth and some amphibians do not. So it is correct. Okay, dear children, the biggest amphibian is the Chinese giant salamander. It can grow to be 6 feet long and weight is 59 kg or 113 pounds. So you all have to do all the full exercise in your book only with the pencil. Okay, dear children.